Okay guys, we'll be opening this iMac. We'll use this. Guys, when you are opening like an iMac, you should be very careful on the cable. When you open the screen like this, check the cable first inside, or else you will break something. These are 10 flex cable that will be easily damaged. So just be careful and check it first. And make sure you are familiar with the lock. There's some type of lock on this cable, so you should be familiar on that one, because if you just pull that out, sometimes those pins are very thin, so it will be easily broken. After removing the cables properly, and then now you can remove the lower side of the screen. Just put something here, like a plastic or like this. I think this is a thin plastic, and insert it here in the bottom. Then slide. Just make sure the adhesive are removed. But make sure to hold the top, because after you slide the plastic here and remove the adhesive, it will fall. So make sure you hold tightly at the top to catch the LCD. This is a old device, not too much dust. Be familiar with this kind of lock like this. and also this slot here is different lock. You should press the side and just pull it out. This here is the same lock as this one. And now, as you can see, there's the RAM. This is the RAM. So, we will see if we can insert the other one. This is the new one. Guys, I just brushed the dust because I cannot stand seeing dust inside the machine or device. I have a customer before, and after I clean the dust, and he asked why I clean it, and he's angry because I think he liked the dust inside his computer, but I cannot stand it, you know. So I hope this customer is not that crazy, same as the customer before. Guys, there were two slots on the RAM, and it is like 4 gigabytes per slot. The customer bring 8 gigabytes, so what we're going to do is to remove one 4 gigabytes and just insert this one. So it should be 12 gigabytes. After, guys, to make it easier for you to remove the RAM, just remove this, the fan. Because rather than removing the whole motherboard, just remove the fan and take out the RAM. I like to have some shortcut. But if you want to just properly change the RAM, you can do that. Remove this the whole board and change the RAM. But it's a lot of work, so I'll just do my thing. If you're gonna do the shortcut thing, you should be very careful, and also you should know what to do, because it is not easy. This is the RAM slot. And it is a backside, all the way there inside. And you should be familiar also the memory slot lock. And you will you need to make sure it is properly installed. So what I did, I just removed the fan here. It is covering the way, and just lose this heatsink. This heatsink from the processor, so I just lose. I just remove the screw so that it can be like, also the motherboard is loosened like this. So I can do like this to the motherboard. I just lose the screw here. I mean, remove the screw, not only not loose, remove the screw, and also just remove some cable. As you can see, there's the RAM, the new RAM, and the 4 gigabytes old one. So now we have to clean this and return everything. It is much better if you have lower. But I cannot do that here because I have a lot of devices here, and I have to bring this outside to blow, to use the blower. So I told you this is just doing the shortcut here, but it is not advisable. By the way guys, I am using Torx screw number 10, T10, for removing the motherboard screw, and also removing the fan. Again guys, this is not the proper way of replacing the RAM. Do not do this if you are not familiar with Apple products and you don't know what you're doing. So I'm just doing the shortcut here, because I don't want to remove everything and put the RAM. But we can do that if we have a lot of time. Sometimes doing the not advisable procedures will save you some time. So now we will return the front panel assembly and make sure it is aligned to the body. Check side to side. If it is aligned, then you can put the cable and close it. Before you close, double check all the lock. It should be locked properly, and you need to make sure everything. For now, we will just put scotch tape just to lock the front panel assembly in place, and while waiting the glue to dry. Guys, curing time, it depends on the glue you use, so you have to check. You have to check the brand of the glue and the curing time of that glue. Now guys, we have to check.
guys, as you can see, from 8 gigabytes, now it is 12 gigabytes. So we will just wait until the glue cured, and we will give this to the customer. It is probably maybe 1 hour or 2 hours. So guys, please subscribe to my channel, and I hope you get some ideas. Now, as I've told you, it is not advisable to do that way, but I know what I am doing, and if you are not sure what you are doing, then don't do it. But if you know what you are doing, then do it. I just do the shortcut thing, then and it works. So I'm not saying we will not do it the right way. Of course, I am doing it the right way every time, but this time I don't have a lot of time, and it is much better, because the customer also said he wants to go to another city this evening, so I need to do that fast. So guys, please subscribe to my channel, and please take good care of yourself, and God bless.